Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I am an adrenal fatigue recovery ninja, and today I want to talk to you about DHEA supplementation for men. I made a video a while ago about DHEA supplementation for women, and I had a viewer ask me, hey, what about DHEA supplementation for men? So that's what I want to talk to you about today. First thing I want to talk to you is that I never make recommendations for DHEA or pregnenolone because without knowing your test results, simply because these are hormones. And I think it is not prudent for us to just go ahead and make a blanket recommendation if you're dealing with an adrenal fatigue problem or hormonal imbalance, energy issues, and we want to help that by just closing our eyes and trying to hit the dartboard and making a recommendation for DHEA or pregnenolone. So that's the first thing I would recommend is, number one, you need to do testing. And there are three different ways that you can test. You can test typically with the blood, with the saliva, and with the urine. I'm not going to make a video right now or talk about the difference of each, but blood is not going to look at your, they all have their benefits and they all have their drawbacks. Blood is the common one that we get done, and certainly if we have elevated levels or diminished levels outside of the ranges, this will certainly tell us what our values are. Saliva is great because it looks at the free fraction of the hormone. It takes into consideration the circadian rhythm, and it's really, really great. The only problem is it doesn't look at all of the metabolites. And that's what urine does. Urine looks at the metabolites, which means it looks at the used up portions and how they break down. It can be done over the course of a day, and it looks at a lot of other variables that we can determine whether or not DHEA or pregnenolone are optimal recommendations. So that's what I do. I like to look at the urine test. However, I'm doing now a combination of urine and saliva because saliva really does look at your circadian rhythms very, very well. So anyways, the next thing I'd like to mention is what factors would impact hormones. And the first one was certainly we need to talk about is blood sugar levels. So you may be wanting to take DHEA or pregnenolone and your blood sugar is not handled, meaning you're not having consistent meals throughout the day, you're not eating a healthy representation of protein, carbs, and fat. You're eating way too much carbs, you're eating not enough fats, maybe you're eating too much protein, you're having a lot of stimulants like caffeine and other things that are really giving you sugar imbalances, and then you're going straight to DHEA and pregnenolone. You need to balance your blood sugar first. The next thing is the adrenals. Obviously, if the adrenals are under an intense amount of stress and we just try to give you pregnenolone and DHEA and we don't try to control the stress and the major things that are impacting that, again, blood sugars being the major one, then I think we're missing the issue. Another thing is absorption. What happens if someone, I had a patient whose cholesterol was 130 and they weren't even taking cholesterol lowering medications. That's way too low. That person needs to help with absorption. There's probably gallbladder issues, liver issues, stomach issues. They're not absorbing fat, or they're simply not getting enough fat in their diet. And I wouldn't go ahead and say, okay, let's get you on some DHEA and pregnenolone when we have to at least deal with the fundamental nutrients, macronutrients in their diet. Obviously, liver, if they're under a lot of stress and their liver enzymes are elevated and they are inflamed and they got a major infection, then the first thing I wouldn't be recommending is DHEA or pregnenolone. Genetics come into play. This is where 23andMe come into play. And this is where we want to look at a person's genotype to see, are they able to break down and absorb B vitamins? Are they able to make SAMe? Are they able to make neurotransmitters? Because if they're not able to do these things, again, I wouldn't necessarily going ahead and ordering, giving someone DHEA and pregnenolone. Lastly, inflammation and injury. And this is what I really want to talk about because there are indications to take DHEA. However, if someone is injured or someone has a lot of inflammation, they're going to aromatize that DHEA, especially for a male. So what does that mean? That means that they are going to get a lot of the sort of the ingredients in a cup that's going to cause overflowing. However, because they're inflamed and they have blood sugar imbalances, insulin resistance, they have an injury, that's going to aromatize into estrogen. And we don't want that. So what patients will do is they'll take something like DIM or 3-carbon indole or something like an estrogen blocker. And they'll say, okay, I'm just going to pour in a lot more ingredients at the top and worry about fixing the way it's funneling down. Whereas I would make the recommendation, let's fix the funnel and let's make sure that we reduce inflammation. We help with digestion, absorption, and gut health. We try to help the liver and detoxify that. We try to balance the blood sugar and eat healthy carbs. And then we can talk about DHEA and pregnenolone. So anyways, I hope you found that informative. My name is Dr. Joel Rosen. You can check me out on Facebook on Adrenal Fatigue Society Recovery, or you can also see me on my YouTube channel, Your Adrenal Fix, or lastly, check out my blog at adrenalfatiguesociety.com. Looking forward to helping you with your adrenal fatigue nightmare. Thank you.